Today we're going to show you how to wire into and program your factory auxiliary switches. And welcome back to the Northridge 4x4 Do-It-Yourself Garage. And yes, today we are going to show you how to wire into the factory auxiliary switch pigtails and program those switches. Now, the last video we showed you how to install the Baja Designs S8 10-inch light bar onto that brand new Grimm Offroad center mount light bracket kit. Since then, we've ran a short little harness from the light up into the engine bay right between the inner fender well and the battery. And that's where you're gonna find the pigtail for those auxiliary switches. So let's take a closer look. Reach down inside the inner fender well and carefully cut the electrical tape, and now the pigtail can slide right out. Now take a utility knife and very carefully cut through the tape. You want to make sure you don't cut into any of the wires down in there. You can also use a real small set of wire cutters and sneak them down through that harness. We're going to cut just enough back that we can expose the wires. With the harness opened up, you can see the four wires for the four auxiliary switches. First up is the beige with the pink stripe, that's for switch number one. Then a green with a pink stripe, that's for switch number two. Then an orange with a pink stripe, that's switch number three. And then a dark blue with a pink stripe, and that's switch number four. Now you can see there's a big size difference between switch one and two and three and four. Switch one and two are rated up to 40 amps, so perfect for larger electrical loads. Let's say a large light array or a 50-inch light bar. The two smaller wires are rated to 15 amps each, so perfect for smaller LED lights or auxiliary radios, anything along those lines. Now for our 10-inch light bar up front, it only pulls 4 amps, so we're going to use one of the smaller 15-amp rated circuits. We'll use switch number 4, so we can just cut the end plug off, strip the wire, throw on some heat shrink, and then a terminal. And heat shrink. Now to wire in our light bar, we can just slide in our connectors. You could hard mount this just with a butt connector, but we like the idea of being able to change out the harness, go to a different light down the road. And then for our ground, we're just going to go right to a ground on the inner fender well. And now we can just take a zip tie and tie that harness back down. And use a set of flush cuts to cut the zip tie. The optional auxiliary switches in the JL and JT. You have auxiliary 1, auxiliary 2. Both of these are the 40 amp circuits. And then auxiliary 3 and auxiliary 4, and both those are 15 amp circuits. Now we've wired our 10-inch light bar into the aux 4 switch, so now we just need to program it up on the main screen. To program our aux switches, hit the stop start button once, then twice, and then we're going to turn on our radio or the multimedia center, and then we'll come over here to settings. Under settings, we can hit the down arrow once, and at the bottom you'll see aux switches. And then here's our four aux switches. We've wired our light bar into aux 4. Let's hit that. Then the type. It's either latching or momentary. Latching means when we push that button, it turns on and stays on until we push the button again. Momentary, it's only gonna turn on when we push the button. And as soon as we release the button, it'll turn off. So we're gonna leave it at latching. Now you can tell it what power source to run. So if we click here for battery, now that'll run directly from the battery. So we can turn that light on at any time. Now we're gonna set it for ignition. So now you can only turn that light bar on when we have the engine running. Now you also have this last line here, which is recalled last state. And what this is this will remember what the button was in its last state. So if you had your light on when you shut the vehicle off, and then you start the vehicle back up, that light will immediately come on. Now we really don't care about that function for this switch, so we're gonna turn it off. Once you're done setting your switch, you can just exit out and you're done. Then we can test our switch. So we'll push aux number 4 and the little light comes on, and sure enough, our light bar is lit. Depress it again and it's off. Now, what if you don't have those auxiliary switches in your JL or JT, but you'd like to add them? Well, Mopar makes it easy with a full kit. Inside the box, you're gonna find the switch panel, the full harness and relay box, brackets, fasteners, even instructions to show you how to do it. And of course, we have them here at Northridge 4x4. So drop right down to that description box below to where you'll find links for the various auxiliary switch kits. You'll also find that like button, hit that, because we gotta know whether you're liking these videos. Hit that subscribe button if you're not subscribed already. And 2021 is gonna be a big year for us. So make sure that you share our videos around. Let your friends know about, well, what we're doing here and those two giveaway Jeeps that we have. Then hit that comment section and let us know, what do you have wired up to your auxiliary switches, or what are you gonna wire up to your auxiliary switches after you install a set? So until next time, thanks, Northridge Nation.